Welcome back to the Fuller Fanatic channel. Today, I'm going to cover a Ferrum Forge design. This is the Odium, produced by Civivi. After covering the specs, I want to speak on why I believe the Odium is the best out of the Ferrum Forge smaller production line, the Pro Series. Coming in with a handle length of 3 54/100 inch, and unlike any build out of the Pro Series, the Odium has contoured handles. At the same time, this makes the handle thickness increase to 43/100 inch. Dressed with the common Civivi right and left hand tip up deep carry pocket clip that's not recessed, this is one of the areas I believe the ProLine's design is better, with a single screw holding the clip in a recessed area at the very end of the handle, an extremely deep carry. The Odium's backspacer extends 2/3 along the rear of the spine, then continues down the backside. Running a liner locking system that, due to the contouring, is exposed in a very subtle way, accenting the build's look. Odium has two means of deploy, the flipper tab and a signature Ferrum Forge opening hole. The tab is on the thinner side, but is very easy to actuate and deploy. The tab's jimping is aggressive and wraps around the entire front side to aid in its deployment. The second deployment option is more convenient for me. As with most Ferrum Forge designs, this sends the fidget factor through the roof. The drop point comes in at 2 65/100 inch in length, with a 2 1/4 inch cutting edge. With a blade thickness of 120/1000 inch, sporting a stonewash D2 steel, the Odium's generous front finger choil allows the user even more control in use. With an overall length of 6.2 inches and a weight of 2.5 ounces, the Odium is an excellent fifth pocket carry. Lighter than all the Pro Series builds, with the exception of the Mini Archie, which I believe many people are aware this is a Mini Malice. But the three main reasons I believe the Odium stands alone is, number one, its weight, which I think can be mainly attributed to the skeletonized liner. Though all the smaller Pro Series builds are just liners under G10, Prolix, nor the Mini Archie have any weight relief going on. This is how the Odium pulled off the feat of being the widest of the group, yet second to the lightest. The second reason, in my opinion, for the Odium being a more robust knife, we must look further into the build to see. Again, the Stinger, Prolix, and Mini Archie are all flat side builds, and even though the blade has milled races for the bearings to rotate in, the frame's construction, spaces, and tolerance calls for the bearings to run along the frame's wall. In the case of the wider contoured Odium, there was enough space to mill a race into the frame's walls, something that's not found on the Pro Series until you step up to the mid-size productions in the line. The dual race channels allow the bearings a lot more protection from dust, debris, etc., while increasing stability in travel and when in use. The Odium is $52, while the other three I named come in at $90. And these are my three main reasons why the Odium, which is not attached to the Pro Series at all, is better than the bunch. In a side note, it's definitely not worth $40 additional, but the triangle face Desert Eagle pivot used in the Pro Series is damn good looking. Which I guess is a perk of we producing the Pro Series. So Civivi, which is we also, it's time to give us some new pivot designs. So please comment down below, hit the like button, share, and sub to the channel. And with that, I'll be signing off from the Fuller Fanatic.